Of experience. Attila's got a deer tail. I should mention we've given these pups nicknames. We haven't formally named the pups because there's actually a name the pup contest through Pair 11, and you can vote on names to give these guys, but we've given them nicknames. Attila is the one chewing on the deer tail. He was given that name because he has a more aggressive personality when it comes to food and eating what he wants. And Red Paw is the slightly larger one, kind of standing up there. When we first got them, it was very difficult to tell them apart because they were so small and they were the same color. So we painted his toenail red. So he got named Red Paw. And the names kind of stuck, and so that's what we call these guys when we're talking about them, when we're interacting with them, until this name the pup contest is complete, which is going to be relatively soon.
This Friday we announce it, or Saturday we announce it.
Next Saturday we announce the pup names. So the pup names are narrowed down to 4 per pup. So if you want to go vote, you have to go online. You can go through wolf.org, which is our website, and there's a link that will take you there, or you can go directly to Care 11. But there's a little red button. You can push it, and pup names come up, and you can vote on which one you like best. And it'll show you which ones are the lead. So this right here, with these guys in this building, is part of the socialization process. We're desensitizing these pups to a variety of people, not just looking at the people, but smelling the people, hearing the people, watching the different movements of the people. So it becomes just something that, that's no big deal. These guys are going to be staying with human handlers until July. So they'll be with handlers 24 hours a day until the beginning of July. And then they're going to start spending more and more time outdoors. So these guys spend time outdoors as it is, not a lot, especially when the weather is cold or rainy. We don't want to compromise their health by letting them get cold and wet outside. But once they're bigger, they're healthier, their immune systems have had time to develop, they're going to start spending a significant amount of their day outdoors, adjacent to our adult wolves. So after they go through this real intense human socialization, they're going to start going into the adult wolf socialization that's more intense, so that they build some social bond between the fence, and then in the beginning of August, we actually let the pups out into our main exhibit with the adults. And once they're out there and everything, they're getting along, then they stay out there until they're retired. How many of you are aware of our retired